Firefighters having a hard time, and they have heavy waterproof coats.
They do, but what about the rest of us? News Channel 8's Jeff Greenwood gets advice from some cold weather wear experts today. Cold weather wear, and we here know how to dress for those outdoor times. Well, I think we do. I bought some socks that are supposed to be good for 40 below.
Well, let's test them out, I think, by this weekend.
We'll need them.
Yeah, well, you know, people like Andy Garman have to brave the elements. We just saw him in Miami outside.
Right.
But today, I get an inside job. Now, many of us must work outside or we simply choose to be there. So here are some do's and don'ts when it comes to staying warm.
I have long johns on and a big scarf, but I am warm right now.
Sarah Galenbeck is on a long walk through downtown Des Moines where the temperature is one digit. Whether you want to be outside or you have to be outside because you're working, there are some do's and don'ts to staying warm in this bitter cold.
Well, don't bare your skin as much as possible, and that means face masks and scarves and stocking caps and things like that.
Frank Markovis of GNL Clothing gives head-to-toe advice to lots of customers who have to work outside.
Gloves with thinsulate, stocking caps with thinsulate, boots with thinsulate in them. That's really important right now.
And inside those boots, wool socks. Unlike cotton, wool stays warm even when it's wet.
Merino wool is soft against the skin. It's not scratchy. You think of wool as a scratchy material, but it's a natural fiber.
Layering is essential. The more layers, the more body heat that gets trapped, and it also stops that cold wind from permeating and taking your heat away.
Brenda Fry at Shields caters to many a recreational outdoors customer.
One of the keys to staying warm outside is the layer of clothing below your clothes. It used to be called thermal underwear. Now it's called the base layer, and instead of the waffle-style material, it's now a newer-style synthetic.
And over the long underwear or base layer, maybe a thin fleece top or sweatshirt, and then a coat and snow pants that block both wind and moisture.
Number one priority is keeping them waterproof or water-repellent to keep the snow from seeping in, and then insulated.
Now for super duper cold, you can't go wrong with a goose down coat, though it is bulkier than synthetics. Now you may look like the Stay Puffed Marshmallow Man, but at least you're warm.
You must be talking about me, because that's what my coat
I've got one
like.
Too, and I'll probably be wearing it Friday.
Okay, thanks.